Yo, it's Mark McInerney, President and CEO of Codemark Financial. Jungle Boogie, burn, burn. The Mortgage Genius. Welcome today to another episode of Music, Mortgages, and Life. All this week we have been talking about, or beginning to talk about, the conversation of renovating homes and remodeling homes because we had discovered that is kind of the new thing now, right? You know, just to kind of take you through the timeline of events of the way that people look at purchasing houses, right? If you're a first-time home buyer, you probably don't have the money to go build that really kick-ass home that you're looking for, you know, as that like one-and-done final home, right? Where you buy the land and you get to work with an architect and your own custom builder and build out everything to your exact liking. So you might start in some sort of tract home in some of these master plan communities, of which a lot of the houses are very cookie-cutter, which is how they're built and why they are built specifically that way. And maybe through the course of living in it, you might want to update it. Maybe, of course, also with the popularity of shows like HGTV, maybe you're looking at some of these older neighborhoods. I know personally, I live in an older neighborhood, an older established neighborhood where the trees are actually bigger than the houses, not the other way around as it is in some of these newer developments. And the houses here, some 1970, almost 50 years ago, were all custom homes and all have their own kind of unique little spin and take on them, and none of them were tract homes back then, which lends a great kind of canvas to be able to go in there and really get very personal with putting our own signature and being able to say, hey, there's not a single house in this neighborhood like this, and now there really isn't, because now we've added our style. So mainly more of my wife's style. So needless to say, how do you do these types of things? Because are you going to max out credit cards to do that? Are you going to, refinance the house? There are actually loans that exist that affords a homeowner, whether it is your primary residence or a secondary residence. What would be a secondary residence? Like, you know, a beach house, a lake house, being where we are in the proximity of Houston, maybe you've got a hill country home outside in Austin or in the wine country area, the hill country area where the vineyards are here. Maybe you've got a house, like a hunting lease, right? I mean, we're all big hunters here in the state of Texas. You know, what about updating that little cabin that we've got, you know, on a few hundred acres? What about investment homes? You know, what about buying those houses that you're buying at the auction block and you want to say, hey, look, I don't want to necessarily put all my own money into it. How do I use the bank's money to leverage the updates that I need so that I can, you know, buy and hold and then lease it out and get some value out of some passive income or for flipping, right? This week I'm going to have my wife in here who does flips. She kind of handles a lot of the investment side of things for our real estate and mortgage conglomerate that we've got. I'm also going to bring in Jennifer McCallum-Obi with Part 3 Realty to talk about some of the tips. She handles all the real estate for the division of that type of things for buying and selling, and she sees a ton of stuff. And plus, she's also got a really good eye on design and the likes of it, so I wanted to get a lady's opinion with style to be able to bring that stuff in. Me, I am the money guy. Remember the Mortgage Genius. So let's talk about what types of loan programs would be available for you to do this. Okay. Home renovations can exist. Home mortgage renovations can exist for whether you're purchasing a house or you're refinancing a house. All right. We're going to talk about the two types of loans that actually exist out there for doing them. Okay. Here are your two types of loans. You can do an FHA loan. As a matter of fact, it's called an FHA 203K loan for the purpose of, applying that loan to do some updates to the house. You can also do a conventional loan, and it's called the Fannie Mae Homestyle Loan. Just say the Homestyle Loan when you call us up, or if you're working with somebody else, just say, hey, look, I saw this really smart guy, this mortgage genius dude, talking about these types of renovation loans, what's this home style loan, you know, that he's talking about? So we'll break these down because there's a lot to kind of know in all of them, but you'll see a little bit of the nuances as we explain them here. The home style loan here, renovation loans on primary residences, on secondary residences, and as well on investment properties, this particular loan can be used for that. Tomorrow when we talk about the FHA 203K loan, you'll see the differences. Here's another thing. It will allow for kind of the lipstick and eyeshadow stuff that we all really like, the luxurious types of updates. And what I mean by that is FHA, for example, is a bit more mechanical and structural. They're more about securing that the house is operating in terms of its bones and structure and function more than you saying, nah, I don't want to put a new roof on it. I really like to have some really nice floors on it. In the Fannie Mae home style loan, they are a little more lenient to saying, yes, you can do a lot of the aesthetic things that are more pleasing and more satisfying, right? Because there's nothing sexy to say, man, I got this great deal on a house and we're updating it. And all your buddies and girlfriends come over and they're like, where are the updates, yo? And you're like, yo, you didn't check out the roof and those gutters, man, it's dope, right? Doesn't make much sense in that case. Also, the home style loans, because they are a conventional product, are going to be a little less lenient in terms of what your credit scores are going to be and also in what your debt to income ratio can be for applying for this type of loan. Let's see, what do I got here? Mortgage insurance. Mortgage insurance is, you know, everybody's least favorite thing about purchasing a house whenever you put down less than 20%. In this case, if you don't have 20% equity into the house, there's going to be mortgage insurance. The good news is it doesn't last forever. It falls off once there's 20% equity established in the house, and it is based largely around the credit score profile of the individual. It's worth noting that insurance, regardless of whatever it is, right? Life insurance, health insurance, mortgage insurance, car insurance, has a lot to do with the insurability of the individual. So somebody with poor credit scores is going to have a much higher mortgage insurance, as is also a car insurance and all that kind of stuff. So this is, you know, it directly is reflected inside of the home purchasing side of things as well. Just know that if there's less than 20% equity inside of what you're purchasing, you will have mortgage insurance. The down payment requirement. In this case, the down payment requirement at minimum is 5%. It's worth noting that there might be some lenders that won't exceed, meaning go under 10%. So you could be needing a minimum of at least 10%, which if that's the case, good. Then you're halfway to that 20% mark for the mortgage insurance being able to fall off. All right, here's the other kind of stickler. The conventional loans, again, since this is a conventional product, this Fannie Mae being one of the gods like Freddie Mac that are the agencies that kind of approve and create the guidelines for all of these loan approvals, this is what they're going to require in terms of the minimum credit score. Some lenders will go as low as 620. Most of them are probably going to be sitting around 640. Remember, it's a risk assessment simply because you are purchasing a house that has updates needed and you're going to be borrowing their money in a draw fashion so that once the loan is closed, you're like, look, yo, I want 10 grand to do this and do this and do this, or 20 or 30 or 40 or 50 grand. So that's okay. Just know that there are loans available to do this. I told you guys, I got your money. Grant Cardone says, where's my money? I say, I got your money. I ain't got his money, but I got your money. You want to learn more about these loan products? You want to talk about to even get pre-approved for them? Bam, right? Mark McInerney, President and CEO, Codemark Financial, the mortgage genius. All right, we're going to like Jungle Boogie out of here. We'll see you tomorrow. I won't be in this week. It's okay.